I'm really excited to show everyone here SureTrack Farm 2.0 this morning. There is a ton of work and effort that's been brought into this, not only by my team, but by many different teams within AGI. Our big goal is to take data from every aspect of the farm and put it into one spot. One of my favorite characterizations that I've heard is that we're building up a Switzerland. It's your data all in one spot. It's all secure and you have control over all of your data. But data is not useful until it's made into information. And I think that's what you'll find as we go through SureTrack Farm, is all of the analyses that we have put up and how we've made that into usable information to bring value to the producer and allow the producer to make more on their bottom line. As we go through here, there's a ton of features that I'm going to show off, and there's also a lot of features I'm not going to have time to show off. Truth be told, this is a culmination of hundreds of thousands of lines of code and many months of work to really craft a product to bring value to the producer. As we set out to build 2.0, we took a hard look at what we had over in SureTrack Farm 1.0. We found that we outgrew the platform. We pushed the limits of the technology. As Todd said, we're really trying to build that muscle car where we're able to do all of the things that we want to do under one hood. But not only that, we took a careful look at our customers. We found that our customers are incredibly busy, that in the planting season, they could be in the cab for 20 hours a day. And then at harvest, they may be doing the same. They just don't have time to use an app for long sessions in a day. So we took a careful look at our app and we wanted to make sure that it was usable on all platforms. We found a lot of our usage was on mobile. So we made sure that no matter what, it looked good in every instance on mobile. Whether you have a really small old iPhone or whether you've got one of the newest phones that's got a bigger screen, we wanted to make sure that everybody was supported. But not only that, it works great on tablets and desktops too. So in its primary form, SureTrack Farm presents itself as a web app that you could just go to a website and use without installing anything. But we also offer desktop apps as well. You can download them for Mac, for Windows, and you can install them and you can have a desktop icon to launch SureTrack Farm or SureTrack Pro. Not only that, we're coming out with native mobile apps so that you can go right to the store, download the app, and it'll be on your phone or your tablet. So before I get started too, one thing that I want to talk about and give special thanks to my team is that we have really crafted a very skilled team of engineers over here. We have brought on specific UX and UI designers that their whole role is to think about how the user actually uses the app. So not only do we make sure that it looks really good, but it works really good. We've brought on QA engineers to ensure that we have awesome quality and that there's no issues with the app. And then we have a team of over a dozen software engineers that are each incredibly skilled and the best of the best. But this really goes past the team that's built this up. As I said before, there was a lot of teams within AGI that came together and coordinated to help build this. So without further ado, I'm a visual person. I like to get in and just show off what we've built. As you guys can see on my screen, for the very first time when a customer logs in, we greet them with a nice pop-up of welcome to the new AGI SureTrack. One of our other initiatives when we set out to redesign was to make a platform that was so easy to use that it didn't require coaching and training. So when we've gone through it, we've embedded education throughout. So you can see that you can watch a video on the left and it'll pop up a full screen video and it'll walk you through all of the changes that we've done since a customer's last been here. Or for a new customer, it'll give an overview of the basic features. Additionally, not everybody wants to watch a video. Some people want to be able to read through a guide at their own pace. So we've got the ability to go ahead and view a guide on SureTrack. Finally, most of our customers are incredibly busy. When they first log in, they're going to be in the production season or they're going to be in harvest. And so we've got the ability to go exactly where they need to go, whether it's looking at their grain storage, taking a look at their fields, or going through our vast wealth of market data. Let's go ahead and get started though. There's a lot going on in this interface, and I kind of want to take it apart and break it down in pieces. In the very top, you'll notice that we have five different pillars: fields, equipment, markets, day-to-day, and traceability. Fields, which we've initially landed on here, is everything that has a latitude and longitude inside of your operation. So whether it's your field boundaries and the telemetry coming off of your tractors, sprayers, planters, and combines, or whether it's your wireless soil probes inside of the field, or even your weather stations that are reading real-time weather readings directly at your fields. We also even will put your grain bins on here because those have a latitude and longitude as well. And when you're busy in the season, you want to be able to check on the condition of your grain, as well as understand which bins are full and which are not. Next up, we've got the equipment pillar. And equipment is all of your devices that report in remotely to us. We'll get into that here in a little bit, but we have everything from 3D visualizations of your entire site and facility to really in-depth visualizations of a grain bin or a mixed flow air dryer. Next up, we've got markets. I'll talk a little bit more about our data set, but we've got over 50,000 grain bids that are being posted by over 5,000 buying locations for over 80 different commodities. And those bids go all the way out from this month, if you were to deliver, to all the way out to 12 to 14 months from now. Next up, we've got day-to-day, which is everything from a bookkeeping and profit and loss system to automated record keeping. Then finally, we've got traceability and sustainability. With all of the incentivizations for embedding data layers for purchasers of grain to incentivizing more sustainable practices, we wanted to take all of the guesswork and paperwork out of that and make it so that it could be as automated as possible, so that producers could get those premiums without putting all of the work into it. They can just focus on what they do best, and that's producing a great commodity and product. Let's dive into the field section more here. You'll notice that we have a map of all of our fields, and we can zoom in on our fields, and we're able to see our latest production layers, our harvest layers, and how much we were yielding in certain spots of the field. We really wanted to provide ground truth to our customers so they could understand exactly what parts of their fields were profitable and which ones were not. But not only that, we provide everything from harvest data layers to spraying data layers to planting. And they can go through each and every commodity and view all of this data one by one. There's a lot of good information that can come out of this to really put facts behind opinions and decisions. Not only do we show from planting, spraying, and harvest though, but we also have many other data layers too. So we can look at everything from how much fuel was used in certain spots of the field, and then you'll start to understand how that later on when we put the profit and loss numbers to this automatically, we can really get down to the penny on how much it costs to produce. I'd like to go a little further though and take a look at what else is on the map. You'll notice that we've got all of these markers here. The blue markers are our wireless soil probes, which are reading in soil temperature and soil moisture. The red marker is our weather station, which is reading in our weather readings from temperature to rain speed to wind, and even provides us a wind rose where we can understand what directions our wind is coming from to make better spraying decisions if we have a spray that it is volatile to drift. You'll also notice that we can see our machinery in the last spots in the field that it was in. And we can also see our grain bins as well. And if we click on one of our grain bins, seeing the inventory and the condition of our inventory is right at our fingertips. So this map operates two ways. I can click on something and view more details, and the map will zoom in automatically for me. Or over on the left sidebar, I've got the ability to go through and choose from different things on the map. So we've divided the left sidebar up into two sections here. We've got the top four, which are things that you'll take a look at every day. And then we've got the bottom four, seed selection, inputs, event plans, and crop plans, which are all part of the planning life cycle and are primarily done in the off season, but also can be used during the production season in order to make better decisions. The top left items though, my fields, my field devices, and my machines, allow you to really get a list of all of your assets. One thing that's really cool that we allow for you to do as well is on that machine telemetry, you can click on one of your machines and you can go into past production seasons and you can view an entire timeline of each and every activity it's done. And you can even go and replay them in real time. Now, watching a combine go through the fields may be a little bit like paint drying. May not be very exciting for most people as you go through it, but you can scrub the bar over and fast forward through the production and really get more information. Want to take a look at event recording. We've got the ability to record many different types of events. Everything from cultivating and spreading to when they actually plant, spray, or even in the future, we're coming out with a scouting feature that makes it really easy to identify disease and insect pressure in the field. To record an event ad hoc, you can come into one of these and you can go ahead and pick what fields you performed the event in. And then you're even able to go in and add inputs and record what inputs and what rates you used. This is our manual way to record events. We actually have an automatic way as well. With our integration with the farmable puck, which provides us that machine telemetry I was showing, we'll detect if you are on the field and if you said that you were going to spray on May 1st and we detect that you are spraying on May 1st or May 2nd, we'll go ahead and we'll send you an email that we automatically recorded the event and ask for any more details that you want to record or confirm. Let's go and take a look at our field system real fast. Each of these fields we can click on and view more details, or we can click on the map and view the details there. We show on the left sidebar a really quick glance of your field. And you can go from our field activity plan, which has weather modeling with a cone of uncertainty of what weather may occur this year for you, based on the last 5 to 10 years of weather data in your exact area. But we also have the ability to go and look at previous activities on your field, where you can go and aggregate all of your data at a glance. So you can see exactly how many bushels came out of the field when you harvested, or exactly how many gallons you sprayed. You'll see here as we get down to the 10th of a gallon sprayed, that when we get into the profit and loss and the costing and the bookkeeping of your operation, that we'll really be able to give you an accurate representation without all of the manual entry. This left sidebar allows you to get a quick glance of what's going on in your field, but at any time on one of these items, you can come down and view it in more detail. And so you can get a full screen representation of it. Here's our field activity plan that I was highlighting earlier. You can see that as our year progresses, our cone of uncertainty will narrow as our possibilities for weather will be more determined. Below, we have a legend for the events that you said you were going to set out in the year for. You can set these events up either manually on a one-by-one basis, or you can use our event planning system to plan the events for 50 plus fields at a time. We've got some smaller farmers in our system, but we also have some producers with over 150 fields and tens of thousands of acres. So we really wanted to make sure that SureTrack Farm could work for farms of any and all sizes. As we progress, you'll see the wealth of information we bring in, from weather forecasting on a daily or even an hourly basis, to really bringing in more in-depth information on the sensors inside of your field. AGI SureTrack manufactures and sells wireless weather stations and wireless soil probes that you can really ground truth the measurements in your field on. Everything from the soil temperature and moisture and the wilting capacity and the soil water potential of your soil, you can really understand when your soil is starting to dry out, and you can really understand what temperature, humidities, and rainfall your fields have experienced. We automatically locate your closest weather station hub, as well as the soil probes that are inside of your field boundaries. I'm going to go ahead and continue on to our bottom four items now. We've got seed selection, inputs, event plans, and crop plans. And they flow chronologically in that order. In the off season, you really need to go ahead and take a look at what varieties of seed you're going to be growing this year. Seed selection is an engine that we've built up. It has over 300 seed companies in it that we've ingested information on, over 50,000 varieties of corn, soy, wheat, rice, sorghum, and peas. And we're working on getting more and more commodities. But for these six commodities, we have taken in over 1.5 million field trials with real information. Whether or not they were performed by a university or they were done by a seed company, we've brought them all into one data warehouse where you can really go through and take a look at the data. At the top of seed selection, we've got all sorts of filters. So you can take a look at the trait and resistances that have been bred into the seed. You can set whether or not you want to take a look at dry land or irrigated only trials. You can even go through and set you're only looking for organic or non-GMO varieties of seed. And we even allow you to filter to only see trials that have been tested on soil types that are like yours. So notice here that we have set up to only look at 100 miles from our location here in Nebraska. And there's over 15,000 trials that have been performed in our area. This really brings power in to understand what's been tested with conditions that are like yours, not something that's halfway across the country. Below, we've got the results of your filters. You can see that we've sorted it descending by yield. So you can take a look through the highest yielding varieties first. You can see what trait stacks have been bred into the variety. And it's as easy as clicking on add to crop plan in order to get growing that in the upcoming season. I want to take a look at how deep our data goes though. For instance, let's take a look at this Agrigold 6499 variety. We're going to load in all of the trials that have been tested in your area, and we'll show map markers for where they were tested at. So because you know your conditions, you'll know if these are accurate trials. On the right side, we'll actually even show a yield ranking graph of where this variety ranked amongst its peers. So you can see that this one at 273 bushels against our over 900,000 corn trials ranked higher than 95% of all varieties we've tested. So this is an incredibly well-tested variety with incredible results. But we want you to take it even further. We'll show you a list of all of the trials that we have, and you can go and click into one of those trials. You can see the information on the trial, such as how many GDUs it occurred, how much rainfall occurred in that year, and then we'll show each and every variety that was tested in that trial, what it yielded, what its test weight and moisture was. And depending on the trial, a lot of them will even report how many plants stood up and when it was planted and when it was harvested. Because a lot of these trials are coming from different cooperators where they fill out everything from pencil and paper to actually doing it digitally, we've aggregated from all of these universities and seed companies, and not all of the data has everything filled out. So as you click through, you'll find that some cooperators are better at reporting than others. And that's the power of the tool, is that you get to go sift through and find exactly what you're looking for. As you find varieties you're interested in, you can favorite them to remember them later and search for them later, and you can go ahead and add to the crop plan. But let's continue on first and let's pick out our inputs. We have built up a library of your inputs. We are using the service called CDMS, which aggregates over 6,000 different inputs and has information on them from whether or not they're organic and to what type they are, such as fungicide, soil amendments, nutrients. In the future, what we're doing is we're tying in with CDMS Check to really automate organic certifications and interactions of chemicals. At any time on one of these inputs, you can go over to the More Info button and you can click on it and you'll be able to view the label that comes right off of the input. And so you can use this to at any point in time on your phone, check on the labels and take a look at the contents as well as the application rates and instructions. I'm going to take you through how to add inputs. It's as easy as coming in and searching by the name of your input. You can start typing a couple letters and instantly we'll show all of the inputs that match that name. And you can go ahead and click add to inventory and it'll be in your input library. The reason why you want to add your inputs into the library is that today, when you go and record events and set up event plans, it allows you to quickly choose from a drop-down of what inputs you said you're going to use. But in the future, we are working with the costing of these inputs. So actually asking for how much you paid, how many gallons that you purchased, and then as we record how much you spray and what rates you sprayed it at, we'll be able to automatically build up your profit and loss without all of the manual entry. Let's continue on to event plans and how you would use these inputs. Event plans are the ability to set up multiple event types and then be able to use them on many fields at once. So I've got a couple event plans set up from organic corn to non-GMO beans. Creating an event plan is really easy. You can come in and say what practice you want it to apply to. And then later on when you go to apply it, we'll make sure that you're not trying to apply a conventional event plan on organic corn. But you can come in and set the practice and what commodity you're going to grow it for. And you'll notice in all of these dialogues, we actually filter out what crops you're growing versus all of the other crops in our system to make it even easier for you to go through our dialogues. But as we're creating our event plan, all we have to do is set what events we want to use. So we can go ahead and we can say that we're going to cultivate before planting and that we're going to spray after planting. And we can come in and set up the timeframes of which this will happen. We allow you to set up timeframes from everything from a date. So you can say that you're going to spray every year on April 29th. But we also allow for dynamic dates as well. You could come in and say that when the commodity has accumulated 400 GDUs, that's when we'll tell you today is time to spray. And as you accumulate sunny days or cloudy days, we'll automatically change the date at which it should occur for you and notify you. Our input dialog down here automatically filters your inputs based on the practice you selected up above. So if you did an organic plan, we would have only shown the organic inputs that you had in your library. But you can pick one of your inputs, set up the spray rate, and it's as easy as that. You can even leave notes for the operator, like check the nozzles. So you can set up many different complex event plans. And as we get into more of the profit and loss in here, we'll actually show how much per acre it's going to cost to do this. Let's continue on to crop plans. Crop plans is an incredibly powerful interface. As I mentioned earlier, we've got farmers with tens of fields and we've got farmers with hundreds of fields. A crop plan allows you to set up in each year what you're going to be doing. And you can change this many different times before the year starts and even after the year starts. So in the 2020 season, which we've defaulted to here, we're able to quickly see what fields we've set up for conventional corn, what fields we've set up for non-GMO beans, as well as organic corn. And we'll be able to see each and every variety that we've set up under each of those plans. So as we pick varieties and we want to try new things out each year, we're going to be able to set up what fields those are assigned to and under what practices. Each of these fields has all of its events assigned to it from an event plan. And you can even come over here and you can assign different event plans and easily swap the events out. One thing you'll notice here too is that we show a column in gray for forecast as well as a column for actual. As all plans change during the year, we want to make sure that while you had a forecast and a plan to set forward on, that you also compare it with what actually happened. So if you weren't able to get on the fields on April 15th and you did it a week earlier, you can come in and manually record. Or as I mentioned earlier, if you have the farmable puck, we'll automatically record what date you did a planting event on, as well as how many seeds per acre that you used. So this crop planning feature is incredibly powerful, and we even provide in tools in order to help you rotate. So when you add fields into a crop plan, we'll actually tell you what the previous crop was and help you understand if you don't want to do corn over corn each year and you want to rotate, we make it very easy to do. That's the field section at a glance. There's a ton of features we went over, and there's even more features that we don't have time to, but we've really made a diverse system to make it very easy in a busy production season to get even more value out of your operation. And while we've done a real overhaul here, we've really only scratched the surface of the value that we can bring to a producer with all of the profit and loss decisions that we can help make. Let's continue on to equipment. Now, when we get into equipment, this is almost a little shocking of a view. We now, and we're the only ones in the industry that show a 3D view of your entire facility and operation. We started off with 3D views of just your grain bin over a year ago because we found that you could really get insights as to how your grain is conditioning. We wanted to take that one step further and give you a 3D view of your entire site so that as we incorporate more and more devices into your farm and SureTrack farm, that you can get these statuses and alerts from them all in one spot. So at the heart, we show the levels of the bins, and you can see how full the bins are at a glance. And we show labels above the bins so that you can understand what variety and how full it is, and a check mark or an alarm mark if there's an issue. You'll also notice that we've got some bucket elevators and we've got some conveyors. We also have a mixed flow air dryer over here. And then even down below, we've got some smaller tanks. You'll notice that our mixed flow air dryer, and this is one of our first integrations we did within AGI, is bringing in the AGI Nico Dryer Master. And we brought in the ability to read out its readings, as well as to show your alarms in real time. And so we can see that our dryer here is in red because we have a burner alarm. And if we wanted to get even more information out of it, we could click on the dryer and view more. We can see up above that our bucket elevator is in red because we have a bearing alarm on its temperature. As we're working with AGI CMC, we are bringing in integrations to all of their handling so that we'll be able to bring in values as well as alarms for conveyors and buckets. This 3D view, while it may seem daunting at first, we've done a lot of work to make sure it works on slow computers, fast computers, on phones, tablets, laptops, or desktops. This 3D view is really easy to use for whether a customer wants to set it up, or whether the salesman is working with them or their customer support rep. At any time, you can go down to the bottom edit, and we're in a 3D editing mode where we can come and we can pick from any of the different devices that we integrate with. Even if we don't have monitoring and automation equipment on your equipment, we want to make sure that you're still able to put everything at your site in this view. So if you have bins without any monitoring on them, you can still come in and set up your bins. All you have to do is type in the dimensions, how many you have, hit create, and then now you have the ability to drag and drop these on a 3D view. If you make a mistake, it's okay. You can go down to the bottom and hit undo at any time. You can also hit redo. And if you click on something, you have the ability to drag it around and fine-tune its position. This works really well on mobile and tablet as well. It may take a little bit of getting used to, but we've done a lot of work to make this as easy as possible and really balance the performance as well as the 3D visualizations. When you're done, you can come and hit the save button, or you can hit cancel and make sure none of your changes were saved if you didn't want to. Let's dive a little further into equipment. On the left sidebar, we have the different equipment we're integrating with. Today, we're working with storage, any kind of grain storage, whether it be bins, silos, piles. We also work with tanks, whether they be fuel, water, propane, lubes, gasoline. We're also working with dryers. Today, we're working with the AGI Nico dryer, but we're also working on getting into stack portable and tower dryers as well. We also work with grain analyzers and testers so that each wagon load you bring in from the field, you can go ahead and test the characteristics on them, because we're finding out that not all corn is the same. That depending on what field, what variety, what spot of the field it comes from, it may have different corn, oil, starch, and protein levels. And instead of putting them all into one bin and averaging them together, we allow for you to test each wagon and separate them out into different bins so that when you go to the markets, you can really get premiums for having that high protein wheat or the high oil soy. Then the three grade options. We're still working on integrating in handling with AGI CMC. We're working with AGI Storm seed treaters in order to get information off of seed treaters, as well as aeration, systems like Easy Dry for top dryers. Let's get some more information. We can either click on one of our items here in the 3D view, or we can go on the left sidebar and click into a specific area. Here, because we don't have so much to render, we can actually show 3D visualizations of the condition inside of your grain bin. And I think this shows even more power to the 3D of when we started doing this, we realized that not all grain conditioned the same. You can see that my bin over here, my high protein oil corn, has this red spot in the middle of it where there's an out of condition pocket that's not conditioning like the rest of the grain. As we click in, we can get even more information. We've got the ability to manipulate our grain bin and rotate it and really get more information. We can see our inventory levels at the top. We even have a playback bar where you can replay and go through the history of how your grain's conditioned. We show your operation mode, your switch positions, and here's where we're getting into the characteristics of your grain. Whether it be the oils, proteins, and starches, as well as each wagon sample that you have tested and assigned to the bin. We'll even show the ranking of all of the varieties we've tested, so you can see that your high protein corn is greater than 98% of varieties that we've tested. And we'll even show on a percentile graph where that ranks. We offer many different views as well. You can go to graph-based views, table-based views, and you can even go to the device logs as well. I want to take you through tanks. As I mentioned, tanks are the ability to monitor the volume of your tanks. We're working with AGI West Steel, and we can do everything from diesel to water to gasoline to propane. And a customer can come in and set up when they want to get alarmed. So they came in and said they wanted to be alarmed at 40% and 15%. And based on the draw rates that we see you using your tank on, we'll even show how many days based on your draw rate it'll take to get down to your thresholds and even to get down to empty. You can even come and set up fill contacts to be automatically alerted. Our dryer integration is really cool. You can in real time see second by second data of the inlet temperature and moisture, each burner and blower's temperature, as well as the outlet temperature and moisture and discharge rate. any alarms will pop up on the left sidebar, as well as be texted or emailed to you as well. You can even go to graph-based views and see how they've trended over time. Changing your target moisture is really easy. You can come in and dial your target moisture, hit save, and within 5 to 10 seconds, your dryer will acknowledge it. Our grain testers, as I mentioned, we have the ability to tie in and have each and every single wagon sample tested for you. And you can see all of the results in real time here and then assign them to what bin you're going to put it in. And then, as I showed earlier, you can see each ticket inside each bin. And this information can be pushed up to purchasers in order to show exactly what they're getting. I'm going to continue on now. We're going to go into the market section now. The market section is incredibly powerful. As I mentioned earlier, over 5,000 purchasing locations, 50,000 different bids daily, 80 different commodities, and we even go from deliveries in the current month, which we see here for April, all the way out to prices in March 2021. In this view, you can instantly see when and where you should sell your grain. You're able to go and set up your cost of production, and you can manually type it in today, but we're working on automating this from all of the features I showed earlier to really calculate your cost of production more accurately. Then you can go through and you can take a look at individual transportation costs and really set up how much it costs to go to a location 50 miles away versus a location 200 miles away. And this view here will then calculate the best price for you each and every single month. You can take a look at the table-based view down below, and you'll be able to see the name of the buyer, what their basis is versus the future, as well as how far that buyer is away and what the profit is for it. You can come in on one of these buyers and click on them and get even more information. So we'll show not only the bid that you clicked on. So in this case, George's is offering $388 if you deliver in July, but they're also offering different prices if you deliver in August or September. I want to quickly show the depth of the billions of price row data that we have here. Right now in the right graph, we're showing how George's has adjusted their price for July delivery over time. In February 10th, that was when they first posted a bid for July delivery at $461. And they've updated it several times a day, and sometimes they've even skipped a couple days. But as they've trended down, you can see that now they're offering $388 a bushel for July delivery. So if you were to check the markets tool back on February 10th and you were to call up George's, you could have gotten $461 a bushel to deliver to them in July. This is one of the reasons why markets is an incredibly powerful tool that every day when you check it, and sometimes even several times inside of a day, the prices are all different and changing. This is the single quickest way for a producer to make more money on their bottom line, of to constantly check this tool and to make decisions of what months they want to deliver their grain in. I want to show one more way in how to make more money in the market section. With this tool here in our graph-based view, this has a producer doing the searching on their own. They go and they hunt where to deliver to. We also have the ability for our purchasers inside of SureTrack to find the producer. But by default, we keep everything private. When a customer first logs in, we prompt them with setting up their market access. By default, we have market access turned off for everybody. But we let you know that if you would like to share the quality of your crop, the oils, the proteins, and the starches, and you want to share how many bushels you have and the approximate location down to the zip code, we won't put a marker on the map for the actual bin location. You can enable market access, and our buyers inside of SureTrack will be able to find you, and they're able to search and sort based on oil, protein, and starch levels inside of their area. And we're finding that they're offering big premiums for this. from tens of cents all the way up to dollars of premiums in order to grow more on quality versus quantity. This is why all the previous tools of maximizing your operation, sorting it into the right bins, and then finding the right buyers really help you out. One last thing, and I want to close this out. I want to talk about data security and privacy. We have 7 different methods for producers to share their data if they choose. We've got the ability for them to add users into their account, and they can just go and quickly create a new user and say, I only want this user to have access to my fields, but I don't want them to view my equipment, my markets, or anything in my account. This is an incredibly easy way to invite in a farmhand, an agronomist, a marketing consultant, and ensure that your information is still private and secure. We also offer the ability to invite in a trusted advisor, like an agronomist as well. So they can go to connections and they can add new advisors this way too. By default, all producers' information is private and secure in our system, but we've always been asked to have more and more ways to share, whether it's they're renting a grain bin to their neighbors down the road, or whether they want to bring in their agronomist to help their production.